So, you just got your ROG Ally and you've installed Windows, but now what? In this video, I'll show you everything that you need to get the most out of your Ally, from essential settings to performance tweaks, controller shortcuts, and more. To make things a bit clearer in this video, I'll be using a Bluetooth mouse just so that my finger doesn't block the screen too much, but you can also control Windows on the Ally with the built-in inputs. The right analog stick moves the mouse. The right bumper is left click and the right trigger is right click. Or you can also just use the touchscreen if that feels more natural to you. The very first thing that you need to do after installing Windows on any device is check the updates. To do this, go to Settings, then click on Windows Update, and then just simply let Windows install all of the required updates. Then open Armoury Crate SE and check for BIOS, firmware, and driver updates. When I got this Ally, I actually needed to update the BIOS, and it was a lot easier than I expected it to be. Lastly, install MyASUS from the Microsoft Store. We'll use this later on in the video to help extend your battery life, but it also includes useful tools like battery diagnostics and health checks. Next, let's fix the display scale. Out of the box, everything looks very tiny on the Ally's 7-inch 1080p screen. Right-click on your desktop, go to Display Settings, and look for Scale. I recommend setting this to 150%. I just find this to be the perfect balance between space and readability. Play around with these settings and find one that works best for you. The next step I recommend is learning the buttons. The Ally has quite a few buttons, and it's worth taking a moment to learn what they do. The left button opens the command center, an overlay for performance mode, screen brightness, FPS limiter, toggles for the keyboard, and more. You can also reboot, shut down, or adjust volume right from the command center. The button on the right with the Armoury Crate logo opens the full Armoury Crate SE app. This gives you deep control over power profiles, lighting, macros, updates, and even joystick calibration. On the back of the Ally, you'll find two extra buttons, M1 and M2. You can map these to just about anything. It's super useful in both gamepad and desktop modes. To customize them, open Armoury Crate. Then go to Control Mode. Then choose the mode that you want to modify. And then click on Key Mapping. In gamepad mode, I've set M1 to act as holding the control button and M2 is to hold Alt. In desktop mode, M1 opens the on-screen keyboard and M2 opens Task Manager. Now, let's activate Battery Care mode. This will prolong your battery life. If you're planning to use the Ally while it's plugged in, I highly recommend turning on Battery Care mode. Open MyASUS. Go to Battery Care and enable the 80% charge limit. This helps to extend the battery life and prevents bloating. If you temporarily need a full charge, just activate Instant Full Charge mode. It'll top the battery to 100% and then re-enable Battery Care mode automatically after 24 hours. Now, let's get creative and make some performance profiles. In Armoury Crate, click on Performance. Then go to Operating Mode. Click on Manual and create two profiles. The first profile will be for when you use the Ally while it's not plugged in. Set the SPL to 18 watts, set SPPT to 20 watts, and finally set FPPT to 25 watts. For fan curves, I recommend this. At 40 degrees Celsius, put the fans on 25%. At 80 degrees Celsius, put the fans on 100%. Do this for both fans. The next profile will be for when you use the Ally while it's plugged in. I call this docked mode, and this offers full performance of the Ally. Set the SPL, SPPT, and FPPT all to the max. For fan curves, at 40 degrees Celsius, put the fans on 50%. At 50 degrees Celsius, put the fans on 100%. When I use the Ally plugged in, I play demanding games and the fan noise doesn't really bother me, but feel free to adjust this to your preference. There's one more thing I want to show you, and this isn't really something you need to do, but it's something that's good to know. You can enable real-time monitoring overlays. In the command center, turn on real-time monitoring. If you want to keep an eye on your frames per second, your temperatures, your wattage output, and more, you can move it around the screen or choose different styles to suit your UI layout. And that's it. You are now ready to get the most out of your ROG Ally with better performance, longer battery life, and way more control. If you have any tips of your own, please drop them in the comments and I'll pin the best ones. And if you found this video useful, please leave it a like and subscribe to my channel.